Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I'm going to talk about standard unreachable added in C++ 23. Let's see exactly what this means. Of course, before I dig into this, I'm going to remind you to check out the video description below for ways that you can support and get involved in this channel and upcoming events that I might have going on. So let's take a quick look at this. This is cbpreference.com, as you can see, which is always my go-to reference for this kind of thing. And it says, standard unreachable. This invokes undefined behavior. An implementation may use this to optimize impossible code branches away, typically in optimized builds, or to trap them to prevent further execution, typically in debug builds. There's lots of typicallys in there, for my taste, and undefined behaviors. So let's look at the actual standardees. And in this case, it says that this function has a precondition that false is true. This precondition cannot be satisfied, thus the behavior of calling unreachable is undefined. End note. So there you have it. It's a function that invokes undefined behavior. Now, the example from the standard is terrible, and I will explain why in a moment. But let's just go ahead and copy it out for the fun of it. So let's go ahead and include the utility header, and we can see that this function, all it does is move EDI into EAX. Well, EAX is the return value from a function returning an int. EDI is this first integer parameter. So it's saying case 0 or case 1, return the value passed in, otherwise default unreachable. So if you reach the end, then undefined behavior will be invoked. So the compiler can remove that code branch entirely. And it is left with just code that basically says return the value passed in. Now, is this going to do something different in an unoptimized build? I don't know. I don't have dash D in debug defined here, but I do have dash 03. And let's see, if I take this down to 0, what does it do? No, even in 0, it does not actually invoke a function anywhere. Okay, let's go back into our optimized build. I think even an 01 is enough to satisfy this. Now, first of all, I do want to point out why I said this is terrible example. And that is because I have the strongly held opinion that you should never have a default case in your switch statements. This function clearly has only one path. It returns a value. If you take every single case label in your switch statement and make it into a return, then you can drastically simplify the nature of most of your switch statements. And you don't have the problem of having a default. Well, let's make a more complicated example. And through the magic of copy and paste, I have a more complicated example ready to go here. Now note, the compiler tells me I have a function with control that reaches the end of a non-void function. And I have an enum struct with exactly three options, and I am properly handling all three of those switch cases here, which might make you ask, how can you possibly have a function that doesn't return? And that is because the allowed actual range of values here is the range of int, because the default underlying type for an enum struct is an int. It is equivalent to as if I had done this. And therefore, I am allowed to pass anything that is within the range of an int. So that's not very helpful. So a lot of people will do something like this. Some sort of error handling routine or something. And this is where things go bad quickly. Because if I add a fourth option to my enumeration, I'm not going to get a warning from the compiler because I have handled every case. I told the compiler that I am perfectly okay with this by having a default case. So really what you should do is make everything a return then have something outside of the switch itself. And let that code be your actual error handling routine. And now I get this enumeration value opt for not handled. Very good. That's what I want. So that is enough of my rant. Now let's get actually back to unreachable. So if you can see here, I have label 4, and this is where an exception is thrown. So it compares the input to the value 1, and if it is 1, then it jumps to L2, where it calls make a string 2. It then compares to the value 2, and if it is not equal to 2, then it jumps down to L7 and compares for 0. If it is 0, then it's going to call make string 1, otherwise it will throw an exception. If the value was 2, then it's going to call make string 3. So the values of our enumeration are 0, 1, and 2. Okay, so this has the proper error handling in it. And we could do something like this, and we see the exact same behavior, except instead of a exception being thrown, it is calling exit. Okay, so let's do the thing that actually is going to invoke undefined behavior. What we are doing here is we are saying this code cannot possibly be reached, so I am going to pass it exactly one of these three values, 1, 2, or 3. Now, this is where I think it is important to point out that what the compiler has chosen to do here is an optimization. It is not by any means guaranteed to be what a compiler is going to do in this case. So I am still at 01 optimization. So let's go ahead and walk through what it did here. If it is 1, then it calls L2, which calls make string 2, and then it jumps back up to L1, where it exits from the function. If the value is not 2, then it jumps to L6, where it simply calls make string 1. So it checks for 1 and 2. If the value is 1, then it calls make string 2. If the value is 2, then it calls make string 3. For any other value, it's calling make string 1, and then falling through to label 1 here, where it is returning from the function. So it said that code is unreachable, so I'm going to pretend like my only two choices are 1, 2, and other. And if I take this back to 0, let's try to walk through this, but I'm afraid it might be a little difficult. Okay, compare to 2, and then jump if equal to L2, okay, and label 2 is where it prints make string 3. And then it compares to 2 again, and it says if it is greater than 2, then jump to L3, where it does something not good. It's returning without setting up anything on the stack. So that is going to truly be undefined behavior invoked because the return value was never initialized. All right. So that is standard unreachable. It is how it differs from having your own kind of exception handler or an exit or something else like that. And that is how it takes advantage of undefined behavior and how it could directly invoke undefined behavior in your code. I don't know where the good use cases for this are, but I do want to point out one last thing. That having an assert in here is going to be kind of like the exception case, except it bothers me in one point, and that is where we tend to define in debug when we're in a release build, which removes the assert, which now means that control reaches the end of the non-void function, which means in release builds, we now get a warning. Well, something to think about. I hope you enjoyed this episode of C++ Weekly. Hope it made sense. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next week.